Hello and welcome to Math with Mrs. Becker. Today in Algebra 2, we are going to finish up section 6.3, where we are dividing polynomials. The first part of the section, we used a process called long division of polynomials. The cool thing with long division is that it always works. Today we're going to look at a shorthand method. So yes, this is a shortcut. It is called synthetic division. Now, synthetic division is super cool, and like I said, it is a shortcut, so it goes pretty quick. However, it does not always work. It works when the divisor is in the form x minus a. So what that means is that whatever you're dividing by has to be just a single variable, no exponents, no coefficients in front, so just a single variable, and then you're adding or subtracting just a number. Then you can use synthetic division. Now what you need to remember is that the formula has a minus. So when you have something like x plus 3, that really is x minus a negative 3, okay, because of the formula. Now this slide is just going ahead and kind of showing you how this all works. When you have a divisor that is in that form x minus a, whatever you are subtracting from x, you put that number in a little box. Now remember, the formula is a minus, so in this case, it's x minus a negative 2. Whatever you're subtracting from x goes in a little box. Then you take just the coefficients of the first polynomial. Again, you need to make sure that they are in standard form, and you do not skip any values of the variable. So here I have 2x's, 1x, no x's. So I don't have to add in any zeros, it's in the right order. I have a 2, I have a 7, and I have a 9. You always drop down the first term. Now I take the bottom number times the number in the box. 2 times negative 2 gets you a negative 4. You add these two numbers together. 7 plus a negative 4 is 3. Now you take the 3 times the negative 2 to get negative 6. Add 9 and a negative 6 make 3. Once you've gone through all the numbers, the last number is always the remainder. The number next to that is your constant, meaning that's your number without a variable. Next to that would have 1x, and if you keep going, the next number would have 2x's, 3x's, 4x's. So this problem is 2x plus 3, a remainder of 3 over x plus 2. Let's go ahead and do some. These are kind of fun, guys. Okay, so again, I can use synthetic division because it is in that format where it's just a single variable and you're adding or subtracting a number. The formula is a minus, so what I'm doing here is I'm actually minusing a negative 3. So negative 3 goes in the box. 2x's, 1x, no x's. So 2, 1, 0. I do not have to add in any zeros. I just take the coefficients. 6, negative 5, negative 6. That is your setup. You always just drop down the first number. So when I drop down 6, now I take 6 times negative 3 and I get negative 18. Negative 18, you add it to the negative 5 and you end up with negative 23. Now I take negative 23 times negative 3 and you get 69. If I take negative 6 plus 69, I get 63. So I made it through all of the values. Okay, so now the last number, this is the remainder. Next to that, that's our number, then that would have 1x. So our solution, our quotient is 6x minus 23. The remainder has a positive value, so it's plus 63 over x plus 3. You just divided using synthetic division. Let's do another one. It is possible that there are times where the number that goes in the box is going to be a fraction, and you can totally do this. You've got this, okay? So 1/3 goes in the box, because what are you subtracting from x? 1/3. 3x squared, 9x, and a negative 2. So again, I did not have to add in any zeros. Drop down the 3. 1/3 of 3 is 1. 9 plus 1 is 10. If I take 10 times 1/3, I get 10/3, which is totally fine. Now here, I need to add those. So if I have negative 2 plus 1 over 10 thirds, you cannot add fractions unless you have a common denominator. So this now becomes negative 6 over 3 plus 10 thirds, making this 4 thirds. Here's your remainder, here's your number, here's your x. You get to have 3x plus 10 plus 4 thirds over x minus 1 third. And for right now, you can just leave your fraction over a fraction. We're not going to worry about that at all because you are focusing on learning a new skill, how you can divide using synthetic division. Okay, let's do another one. X plus 2. So what are we subtracting from x? We're subtracting a negative 2. 4x's, 3x's, 1x, no x's. You cannot go 4, 3, 1, 0. We need a 2 in there, so it's 4, 3, 2, 1, 0. 3, negative 1, 0 for the x squared, 5, negative 1. Carry down the first term. It's a 3. 3 times negative 2 is negative 6. Add, negative 1 plus negative 6 is negative 7. Multiply, negative 7 times negative 2 is 14. Add, 0 plus 14 is 14. Multiply, 14 times negative 2 is negative 28. Add, positive 5 plus a negative 28 is negative 23. Multiply, negative 23 times a negative 2 is a positive 46. Add, negative 1 plus 46 is 45. So I went through and I used all of the numbers. The last number is always the remainder. Next to the remainder is a constant. The next term would have 1x. The following would have 2x's and then 3x's. So your final answer, we have 3x cubed minus 7x squared. This is positive. So plus 14x minus 23. The remainder is positive, so it's 45 over x plus 2. See how much quicker that is? I mean, think back when we were doing long division at the beginning of the section. This is so much quicker because you're eliminating all of the variables. You only look at the numbers during the process, and then you add the letters in back at the end. Okay, let's look at another one. We are in the form x minus 6. Whatever you're subtracting from x, that goes in the box. 2x's, 1x's, no x's, so I do not have to add in any zeros. 1, negative 3, negative 18. Carry down the 1. 1 times 6 is 6. Negative 3 plus 6 is 3. 3 times 6 is 18. Negative 18 plus 18 is 0. So this has no remainder. Your remainder ended up being 0, but the last number still represents the remainder. So when it's a 0, it just means this divides perfectly. So we have no remainder. This is our number. This is our x. So our solution is x plus 3. Okay, let's keep on going. Now, this is something that is super cool. Okay, a lot of times when you do something in math, you can actually use it for various reasons or various tasks. Synthetic division is another way that you can actually evaluate a polynomial. And so what this means, like if I have x cubed minus 4x squared plus 5x plus 1, and I do synthetic division with a 3 in the box, what the remainder is, that is the same value as if I took this polynomial and I change all the x's to a 3. So like if I went 3 cubed minus 4 times 3 squared plus 5 times 3 plus 1, you would end up with the same remainder. So it is so cool. That's why it's called the remainder theorem. And it only works with synthetic division. But again, what the remainder theorem states, the number that's in the box, okay, that is the value that if you plugged it into the original polynomial, you would get the value that matches the remainder from synthetic division. So we're going to do a couple. You guys, this is so stinking cool. So they said, okay, well, if you want to know what this is equal to, if you want to evaluate it for x equals 2, one method besides just going and filling it in, put the 2 in the box for synthetic division. Then it's 2, 5, negative 1, 7. It's all set up for us. Bring down the 2. 2 times 2 is 4. Add 5 plus 4 is 9. Multiply. 9 times 2 is 18. Add. 18 plus a negative 1 is 17. Multiply. 17 times 2 is 34. Add. 7 plus 34 is 41. So if this is true, I can take the polynomial, put in a 2, and I should end up getting a 41. So 2 times 2 cubed plus 5 times 2 squared minus 2 plus 7. Let's do it. So 2 times 2 to the power of 3 plus 5 times 2 squared minus 2 plus 7. 41. So if you fill the number that's in the box into the polynomial for all of the x's, the value is going to be the same as the remainder when you do synthetic division. How stinking cool is that? This is why math is so cool. Okay, not only can we like divide polynomials, but you can also evaluate polynomials both using synthetic division. Okay, let's do a couple more. Now they want to know, okay, what is the value of this? 6x to the power of 4 minus 25x cubed minus 3x plus 5 if you replace the x's with a negative 1/3. Well, if you want to know what the value would be, one method is putting that value in the box for synthetic division. Notice we have 4x's, 3x's, 1x, none. You can't go 4, 3, 1, 0. You need that 2 there. So this is a 6. Negative 25, 0, negative 3, and 5. Carry down the 6. Positive times a negative, I know it's going to be negative. 1/3 of 6 is 2. Negative 25 plus negative 2 is negative 27. Negative times a negative is a positive. 1/3 of 27 is 9. 0 plus 9 is 9. 9. So positive times a negative, again, that's going to be negative. 1/3 of 9, it's the same thing as 9 divided by 3, that's a 3. Negative 3 plus negative 3 is a negative 6. Negative times a negative, it's going to be positive. 1/3 of 6 is 2. 5 plus 2 is 7. Here is your remainder. So what that means is that polynomial, if I fill in a negative 1/3 for all of the x's, the value would be a 7. So synthetic division can be used to divide polynomials and also evaluate polynomials. All right, last question. If I want to know what x cubed plus 3x squared plus 4 is, if I replace all of the x's with a negative 3, besides just replacing the x's with a negative 3 and plugging it in your calculator, you can always use synthetic division. 3x is 2x's, here's 1x, no x's. 1, 3, 0, 4. Bring down the 1. 1 times negative 3 is negative 3. 3 plus negative 3 is 0. 0 times negative 3 is 0. 0 plus 0 is 0. 0 times negative 3 is 0. 4 plus 0 is 4. This is something that can happen when you're doing synthetic division. It's very common to get like a big chunk of zeros. So when that does happen, please don't be alarmed. Totally normal, okay? When you are evaluating, that's called the remainder theorem. Your solution is the remainder. So that polynomial, if I replace all the x's with a negative 3, I would have a value of 4. And today we are not going to worry about the book assignment. What I have for you as an assignment is a worksheet. Your worksheet is going to have you practice long division, just to make sure that we're comfortable with that, because remember, long division works all the time. Okay, synthetic division, that's our new skill for the day. Notice when you're doing synthetic division, it's always a single variable, plus or minus a number. And then it's called synthetic substitution. So you're going to evaluate this polynomial for this value of x, but you're not plugging it in. You're going to use synthetic division and the remainder theorem. The remainder is going to be your answer. So that will be your assignment for the day. Again, do not worry about the book assignment. I hope you enjoyed learning about synthetic division, and I'll talk to you soon.